Hello everyone, welcome back to Conan Experts, and today we are proceeding where we left off. We were configuring a small office space, and in the small office space configuration that we had, I have decided to change a number of things and try a different, more modern approach. So as you can see, we have from the top left corner, we have our server room, we have a server switch, we have a router A, which is also our main access gateway. And then we have a main switch. From the main switch, we'll connect various networks, and on the various networks we'll have an admin room, we'll have an IT staff room, we'll have end security devices network, we'll also have manufacturing, common management, management cluster, among so many other things that we'll have to configure in a step-by-step series, and I'll divide this into a number of videos. Before I go any further, if you like the videos, hit that thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe to the channel, like, share, and we'll grow together. So just a brief overview. In this cluster, I'll have a PC and I'll have a phone, an IP phone, in order to make sure that I am utilizing my network resources effectively, because otherwise you don't need to lay extra infrastructure for the analog phones when you have IP phones. I'll have a home wireless gateway. I have an admin cluster where I'll be showing configuration on a laptop and on a desktop, which is very, very similar. Again, an IP phone. Moving on, we have a common room, and in the common room we'll also have a phone and a printer, and we'll have a management cluster room. I'll use just one PC and a wireless gateway to demonstrate that. So to aid in, I'd say, to smoothen the tutorials, I have come up with a list, a checklist of sorts, and in this checklist we will go through it step by step, and this is what we will be doing. So in today's video, I'll simply show you how to name a router, setting the host name, to set up an MOTD, to disable DNS lookup. I'll also show you how to set up a password for your configuration, and to set up an encryption password, to set up a minimum length for your passwords, and essentially to encrypt all passwords that you may decide to set up on that router or on that switch. Now, everything I'll be doing here, I'll be working specifically on the router, and as you proceed, you'll see we'll start assigning IP addresses, we'll start doing cryptography, we'll start checking for SSH, these secure shell transmissions, we'll also set up VLANs, and all of this will come in a series of videos. So stay tuned and let's get right to it. So our first checklist is setting up a hostname, an MOTD banner, disabling DNS lookup, and pointing our domain name to rap.net.com. So I had configured this one earlier on, so let's just delete that one, bring in a new router. So now that we have our new router here, we can quickly go in and we'll see that routers always offer an automatic configuration, but on this one we'll just quickly hit no, because we want to do it on ourselves and we want to learn. So just type in no, begin, enable. Oh, and another thing, I don't know if I mentioned this earlier on, but with the iOS, just typing in the short version, the first 2-3 characters of a word, provided there is no other similar word in that specific configuration menu, then it will just complete everything for you. So me writing conftar is the same thing as writing configure terminal, and this essentially helps you move a lot faster in your work. So let's set up a host name as per the instructions. It's gonna be router A. Next thing, we need to set up a banner, message of the day that is. So banner MOTD hashtag means that whatever I write the moment the console sees the character hash, that means that's the end of the message. So what do we write here? Also notice that once I'm satisfied with whatever I want to be the message of the day, I have to end with that hashtag, and that's how it will recognize my input. So next thing, we want to set up a password for enable. Let's set up the password as per the instructions. We were required to use wrap-exec as a password, and then we need the console access password to be wrapcon. Now there are two ways to put this. You can either use enable password, or you can use enable secret. Now for enable password, I'll just copy this wrap-exec pass. Let's just put that in, and now we'll enable secret, and the secret will put wrapcon pass. So now that's done, what else do we need to do? We need to disable DNS lookup. This is a very, very nasty thing. So what do we do? Type in IP, look at all you have, and you can see we have domain lookup. This is what we want to disable. So how do you disable? Essentially with the iOS, the moment you put no, you are negating any other command later on. So we'll just do that, and that's it. The lookup is gone. Now we need to set our domain name to wrap-net. So we put in domain wrap-net.com. Oh, sorry for that. Syntax is key here. Yep, now that should work perfectly. Yes, that should work very, very well. So what else is left? We have done this, we have done the multi-D banner, we have put in the privilege exec password, console password. Now we need to enforce the character length. How do you enforce character length? This is a feature called security. Quickly checking that, you see that under security we have passwords. Under passwords we will have minimum length. So in our instruction set, we are required to set a minimum length of 10 characters. So we can put that in. We want the minimum length to be 10 characters. Just talk too much. So we want our minimum length to be 10 characters, and that is securely put in. So for example, if I wanted to put in enable password and say Conan, this is clearly shorter than 10 words of 10 characters. So what does it tell me? It tells me that the password is too short. So essentially we've done the first test and we have passed that one. So we need to check and confirm that everything else is as expected. So I have quickly exited the console. Now I want to start up, and we are greeted with IMOTD. This Hatimina router. Sorry about that one. So this is what, whenever you are connecting to that router, that switch, or that Cisco device, and you want to configure the device, immediately you connect it and the device powers up, or obviously it will be powered up, this is the first thing you see. This is the message of the day. So this is more of a communication from me to you, or me to the next person who will be configuring the router, telling them of that key information that I want them to know about. So for example, if we are working in shifts and there's an IT guy coming in at night, I want him to know that this router is off bounds. You should not touch this one. And MOTD is one of the ways to communicate. Now, should that person decide to ignore your request or your MOTD, and goes ahead and types in enable, you will have already set in a password for that. And you remember our password was what? RapConPass. So before I hit enter, you've noticed that I have typed in, but we cannot see the password. This is one of the good key features in terms of security, because for starters, you don't want the other person knowing your password length. Trust me, that's one of the worst ways to begin any security venture. If I know your password length and I do some basic social engineering on you, then I'll have come up with a key set of words or structure of words that I'd expect you to put in. And if I know your password length is exactly 10, then I can easily hack you by trying brute force attacks with a specific set of key characters at a specific length. So yeah, now we need to ensure that all our passwords terminal so we need to ensure that our passwords are encrypted. And how do we do that? We can simply write do show running conf, and because I don't want to see everything, I can just write in include enable. And you, what do we see here? We see that we have two passwords. We have the enable secret, which is the one we've used, the RapConPass, and we have a enable password RapExecPass. So again, in our instruction set, we were supposed to encrypt all clear text passwords. We did not do that. How do you do that? Config terminal, and I'll write in service. We are looking for an encryption service. This is the password encryption service. This will essentially encrypt all clear text passwords that have already been set up and those that will be set up in the future. So what have we done? I've written, yeah, essentially when you put in a question mark and you receive a CR, it means that that is correct. So if we were to do a do show running conf, sorry, again, filter by include, and we just want to see enable, we will notice there's a slight difference in what we saw the last time and what we see now, in that both passwords are encrypted in different protocols. So these are one of the key ways that you can build the security of your network from the ground up as you configure that network. Essentially, before going any further, before starting assigning IP addresses and so on and so on and so on, it's always recommended to set up passwords, to encrypt your passwords, to hide all clear text passwords, and also to disable DNS lookup, because DNS lookup is one of the few ways that you can inject a malware into a program, or by pointing the router to a specific DNS, whereby when it goes to that DNS, you can have a set of instructions that require to download quote unquote a patch update, which now will be malicious and will essentially give you a gateway or a backdoor into that network. So in the next video, we'll be creating an admin user, we'll set VDI lines, we'll look into SSH configuration. If you like the videos, hit that thumbs up, like, share, and make sure you subscribe to the channel. I'll be seeing you next week. Thank you.